So in last video we saw what is current and what is current density. So current is a rate of flow of charge and current density is the current flowing normal to the surface area. Unit surface area is called as current density. So next we will obtain what is the relation between rho v and the current density, that is volume charge density and current density. For that I am considering a volume v. So here I am considering volume V, which is having the volume charge density of rho V. So in this volume I am considering one more volume that is having a small, in this total volume V I am considering a small volume of delta V. So which is a considered as an incremental volume, which is having a volume of delta V, and the one surface of that incremental volume is delta S, and the length of that incremental volume is considered as delta L. Here in this derivation I am considering the normal V, letter V as a volume, and the italic letter V as a velocity. So we know that the unit of the velocity is meter per second, and the unit of rho V is meter per coulomb per meter cube, and the unit of the current density is ampere per meter square. We will see in this, at the end of this derivation, we will see how this, the volume charge density and current density are related to each other. So here if I consider this volume of small incremental volume, so then in a volume charge distribution I can write the charge as rho v into delta v. So delta q is equal to rho v into delta V, right? So I can write delta Q is equal to volume charge density into the that incremental volume. So here I am considering, as I told before, I am considering a small surface area that is a part of delta V as delta S, and the length, incremental length, as delta L. Now I can write the volume as delta V, which is equal to, it is the product of the surface area and this length. It is a product of surface area and this length will give me the volume, that is delta S is equal to delta V is equal to delta S into delta L. Now I will substitute this equation 2 in this equation 1, then delta Q can be written as rho V into delta S into delta L. Now I am moving this small elemental area in the direction of X. So the direction of the direction in which this small incremental area is moving in the direction of X. So with the velocity of V, the component, so this volume is moving in the direction of the X. So I am considering the component of velocity as Vx. So I am considering the velocity component as Vx, because the movement of this box, that is volume, in the direction of X. So I am considering component of velocity also Vx. So if I move that particular volume by a length of delta x in a delta t time, so I am moving this volume charge from here to here with a length of delta x in a particular time of delta t, then I can say the current is equal to I is equal to delta q by delta t. Delta Q is the charge in this volume. I move this charge from here to here with a time span of delta T with the displacement of delta X. So I can write the current in by the movement of this charge is produced is delta Q by delta T. That is charge per second, that's coulomb per second, that's charge per second, which is equal to delta I is equal to delta Q by delta T. Now, so what is Q as per equation 2? Q is equal to delta Q is equal to rho V into delta S into delta L. But what is the displacement here taken place? The displacement is delta X. So here delta L is replaced by what is the displacement length. So we can write delta Q is equal to rho V into delta S into delta X. So if you substitute this equation 4 in equation 3, you will get delta I is equal to rho V into delta S into delta X by delta T. So we know that what is velocity? Velocity is displacement by time. That is displacement by time. Distance traveled divided by time. That is V is equal to displacement by time. So we can write delta x by delta t, if it is the this charge is moved delta x distance in the delta t time, then I can write delta x by delta t which is equal to velocity in the direction of x. So delta x by delta t which is equal to vx, which is taken as vx. Now if by substituting this delta I is delta x by delta t which is equal to vx in the equation 5, I'll get delta I is equal to rho v into delta s into vx. So we know that delta I is equal to current density into surface area, right? So delta I is equal to current density into surface area. So I can write this equation as j into delta s, which is equal to rho v into delta s into vx. So delta s get cancelled. So I can write the component in the direction of x, the current density component in the direction of x, which is equal to jx, which is equal to rho v into vx. So in general, I can write j is equal to rho v into velocity. This is the relation between current density and volume charge density. So current density is equal to volume charge density into velocity of the movement of charges will give me the current density. So next we will see what is the continuity equation. So continuity equation is mainly based on the principle of conservation of charges. This principle says that we can't destroy or we can't create a charge or we can't destroy the charges. So charges cannot be created, cannot be destroyed also. So we also know that the current equation with respect to the current density, we can write current equation as I is equal to surface integral of j dot ds. Now if I consider definition of the current is considered as it is a flow of positive charges, because the direction of the current is in the opposite direction of the flow of electrons. Now if I consider a closed surface, in that closed surface, if I having a charge of qi, if I consider a closed surface, if I having a charge of qi in the closed surface, now these charges are started to move outward of that closed surface. If that qi charges is started to move from that closed surface to outside, then the flow of current, that is the flow of charge, can be outward flow of the charge can be equated to the what is a decrease in the number of the charges, right? Rate of decrease of the charges can be equated to rate of flow of charges, outward flow of the charges. So if I consider qi as the charge inside the closed surface, then the rate of decrease of the charge can be written as minus dqi by dt, because minus is because decrease in the charge, so that's why I am taking minus dq by dt. Now I can relate this rate of outward flow of positive charges is a current, so which is equal to minus dq by dt. So I is equal to minus dq by dt. So using this equation, I know I is equal to the surface integral of j dot ds. Substituting this, I'll get the I is equal to surface integral of j dot ds, which is equal to minus dq by dt. So this equation is called as the continuity equation in integral form or integral form of continuity equation. So now to obtain the equation in point form, we will use this equation and we will derive the equation, the continuity equation of the current in point form or differential form. Now I am considering, I already told current is flowing outward from the surface. So that current is considered as negative current. So then that equation can be written as minus I is equal to, what is I? I is equal to minus dq by dt. So if the current is negative, then minus I is equal to dq by dt. Now what is I? I is the surface integral of j dot ds, which is equal to dq by dt. Now we know that divergence theorem. So according to divergence theorem, we can convert surface integral into volume integral. So using divergence theorem, you can convert into surface integral into volume integral, right? So we can write this equation j dot the surface integral in terms of volume integral. So using divergence theorem, I can write volume integral, that is surface integral with j dot ds, which is equal to volume integral of del dot j into dv. The surface integral j dot ds, which is equal to volume integral of del dot j into dv. So substituting this in this equation, I'll get d cube minus d cube by dt, which is equal to volume integral of del dot j into dv. Just substitute del dot j, volume integral of del dot j dv in this equation, you will get minus d cube by dt is equal to volume integral of del dot j into dv. Now, what is this q in terms of volume, in terms of volume, in volume charge condition, volume charge distribution? I can write charge qi, which is equal to rho v into dv, volume integral of rho v into dv. The in a volume charge, the qi can be written as volume integral of rho v into dv. So substituting this qi in this equation, I'll get the differentiation of d by dt of volume integral of rho v dv, which is equal to volume integral of del dot j into dv. Now, so in a closed, if the surface is always constant, then this differentiation, this derivative will be converted into partial derivative. As per the law of the differentiation, if it is the surface is constant, then this derivative d by dt can be converted into partial derivative. So using this, we can write the volume integral of del dot j dv, which is equal to the minus volume integral of dou rho v by dou t into dv. Now, if this volume integral holds good for every case, then we can write the, instead of this differential volume, I will consider the incremental volume, and by considering incremental volume, I can write del dot j into delta v, which is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t into delta v. So if this equation holds good for all the parts of the volume, then this equation can be written as incremental volume, that is delta v, that is del dot j into delta v, which is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t into delta v. So this delta v get cancelled. So I can write del dot j, which is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. So this equation is called as the point form of continuity equation of current, or differential form of continuity equation of current. This is point form or differential form of continuity equation of current, which is equal to del dot j, which is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Now, for a steady state current, in the case of if the current is steady state, then there is no change in the value of current. If the in a steady state, there is no change in the value of current. So if there is no change in the value of the current, then what is the rate of flow of charge? Rate of flow of charge, the rate of flow of charge also constant. Then what is the volume charge? This term dou rho v by dou t for a steady state current, it will become zero because there is no change in the value of current. So dou rho v by dou t will be equal to zero. So we can get for a steady state current, dou rho v by dou t is equal to zero because there is no, the charge is constant, the rate of flow of charge is constant. So we can take dou rho v by dou t is equal to zero. And that's why continuity equation for a steady state current is del dot j, which is equal to zero. So this is the equation for continuity equation in a point form for a steady state current. And this is the continuity equation of the current in point form or differential form, that is del dot j is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. And so this is the equation, continuity equation of the current in integral form, that is I is equal to surface integral of j dot ds minus dq by dt. So this is the continuity equation of the current in point form and integral form. In next videos, we will see what is the conductors and dielectrics. Thank you.